The Yankees did absolutely what they needed to do, and that was sweep the Texas Rangers and winning this particular game 7-3. This game did not look pretty early for the Yankees. They were down 3-0 in this one, and it was not the sharpest of days for Corey Kluber. You know, he did get unlucky, some weak contact that found some holes, some grounders that found some spots. But to go 4 1/3, 8 hits, 3 runs, it's not really what you love to see. You know, Boone didn't think he was necessarily bad in this one, but you have to pitch a little bit deeper in this one, give up a little less contact. It was Wandy Peralta who relieved him, and he becomes kind of an unsung hero. You know, he's someone you may forget about looking back at this game, but he got out of Kluber's mess that was hurt by a really bad Luke Voit error, first and third. One out for the Rangers. They had a chance to blow it open, up 3-0. He gets out of that. He then follows that up with a 1-2-3 inning, and it allowed the Yankees' bats to wake up in this one in the fifth. They responded to 2 runs in that inning off the bat of Kyle Higashioka, with a really great day at the plate, 2-for-3. His one out was a rocket to center. He would get gunned out at home this inning, though, trying to score on a flyout from DJ LeMahieu. It gave the Yankees 21 outs at home this year, the most in the majors. Weird kind of blip in the radar for the Yankees. They need to get better on the bases, obviously, as we know. Ton of outs overall left on the field. And then the Yankees did catch a break to tie this thing at 3 with bases loaded, 2 outs in the next inning. You know, Gleyber Torres had a really bad strikeout. Then Gio Urshela steps up. But the break is a wild pitch. It ties things at 3. The Yankees did not get the big hit early in this one. They needed to get bailed out by that wild pitch. But you have to also shift your attention to the bullpen. They were shut down. They gave the bats a chance to finally wake up. Wandy Peralta was followed by Clay Holmes. He tossed a 1-2-3. Chad Green pitched a scoreless as well. And it did give them a chance finally to break this one open. And they had a golden chance in the 7th. To do just that, runner on third, one out, thanks to a bloop single by Kyle Higashioka, and then 2 stolen bases by Tyler Wade, who pinch ran for him. But DJ LeMahieu struck out, really bad at bat for him, really bad day for him, 0-for-5. You know, he failed in a number of big spots. If this game goes differently for the Yankees, he could be the story and his struggles and how the Yankees refuse to move him out of the leadoff spot, despite him not really deserving it all season long. But the one positive thing this inning did do is it got Gary Sanchez in this game. It also marked the 4th time in this game the Yankees failed to get an RBI with a runner on third and less than 2 outs. So very bad situational baseball for the Yankees in this one. But back to Gary Sanchez, who gunned out a runner in the top of the 8th, a laser perfect throw from him, and then he made some more damage in the bottom half of that inning. You know, that really started 2 outs and 2 strikes. Joey Gallo at the plate, a bloop double by him. It sets up Gleyber Torres, who struggled early in this one. He gets his biggest hit of the season. On the first pitch he sees, he rips a double down the right field line, giving the Yankees a 4-3 lead, their first lead in this one. And then the fun did continue. Gio Urshela hits a grounder to second, tough play, but it gets under the glove of Hernandez, and Gleyber Torres hustling all the way around. He scores from second, a great slide from him. The ball definitely beat him, but it gave the Yankees a 2-run lead. And then it was Gary Sanchez, who I just mentioned. He continued his really nice short night for the Yankees. He had a bomb to center field. It opened it to 7-3. Aroldis Chapman came in for the 9th. He looked great. He put the Rangers down 1-2-3. And most importantly, it got the Yankees back into a playoff spot as the Blue Jays lost earlier in the day to the Tampa Bay Rays. You know, the Yankees, they are now in control of their destiny. It is in their hands. They play all the teams they are battling with, and that is something they do know. It's something Boone talked about after this one.
What's comforting is we're in control of things. And, you know, regardless of what would have happened tonight, we're in control of things. Regardless of what happens to start this trip, we're in control of things. And, you know, there's some comfort in that. You know, it's on us. It's right in front of us. We go out and play well, we'll get to where we want to go. We're going home. So there's some comfort in knowing that, you know, we don't have to get help from anyone else. We don't have to look to anyone else. It's on us.
And looking back, this game could end up being a complete afterthought for the Yankees because they need to take care of business coming up. But this was a mandatory sweep against a terrible Rangers team. It's exactly what they did. And now you look ahead, it's on the road to Fenway, then in Toronto, and then you come back home versus the Rays, a series you really hope matters at the end of the day. It easily can't if they struggle in these next two, with these two teams that they're bouncing around here. And as we've talked about, it really is in their hands. They really do have control of their destiny. They'll have an off day tomorrow, and then it's Friday night with the Rays, Gerrit Cole on the mound. He'll try to bounce back after that really bad start versus the Indians, and he'll need to bounce back if the Yankees really do want to have a shot at the playoffs. It should be a fun one, and we're going to have it all covered for WFUV Sports, as I'm Ryan Gregoire, reporting live from Yankee Stadium.